so delighted to be here with all of you guys in this incredible bookstore. This is my first time here, but I've heard about it for years and years and years, and it's good to finally sit by and see that all the wonderful things are true. So thank you, Sherry, for putting this all together, the musicians for bringing us all here. My book is smack dab in the middle of Maybe, and I'd like to show you the beautiful artwork that Amy Esslinger created around the book. The book has a clue tree. I'll give you here more about that in a second, and includes a little bit of poetry by Emily Dickinson, and that's inspired by that. So the book began. Two of my favorite books growing up were My Side of the Mountain. Has anyone here read that or had it? I love how that book took readers on an adventure to survive in the wild. My second favorite book, and this may go back a number of years for some of you guys, is from the Mixed Up Files of Mrs. Basil Lee Frankweiler, which takes readers on a clue trail. And they, a brother and sister run away to the Metropolitan Museum of Art and discover this art mystery. And they have to solve a series of clues in order to figure it out. So I challenged myself to put together outdoor survival and an art mystery clue trail in one book. And I grew up in Mississippi, and the book is set entirely in Mississippi. It's a very southern book. For the clue trail, I was inspired. Has anyone here heard of the artist Walter Anderson? I didn't think so. He was a very reclusive and mysterious artist. He worked mostly in isolation, and he painted a lot on typewriter paper, and he did murals. And he painted in this little cottage on the Mississippi Gulf Coast, and he painted the things that he saw. He did mostly wildlife and scenes from nature. And when he passed away, they went to his cottage. Everything looked pretty much normal, like a normal cottage, except for one room. And that room was locked. They didn't have a key. And they didn't know if they wanted to know what was in that room. But they got up their nerve, they broke their lock, and they stepped inside, and what they saw took their breath away. Because he painted the ceiling, the floors, and the walls to reflect a day in his world on the Mississippi Gulf Coast. So as the first ray of sun came in from the east, it shined on a painting that he'd done of a rooster who was crowing to start the day. As the sun moved around the sky, he used the sky like a spotlight to make you see exactly what he wanted you to see at the exact moment that he wanted you to see it. So it would land on paintings of rabbits and squirrels and lizards. And outside the room, you would hear rabbits and squirrels and lizards skittering through the grasses.